got through it. Well, it has been a good, solid period here so far. The Jackets right now maintaining some pressure.
Oh,
baby.
Oh, did Anisimov get hit? And the Jackets take exception to that.
Because Jeffy's up. Look at that hit. And that's a solid hit by Francois Beauchemin. That's exactly what 23 can do. He did it here at the Jackets. He's done it in Toronto. He's done it in Montreal. And you can see Nick Foligno coming in after the fact.
Thomas Erick steps up, takes a bump as he dumps the puck in. Chris Phillips is there, back to center. DaCosta chased by, oh, what a big hit. Dion Phaneuf stepped up and got DaCosta. Right in the middle of the ice, and that was a patented Dion Phaneuf step up and hit.
And Dion has said it's not going to change his game, and he could still be aggressive. Last week, Don Cherry showed the hits by Scott Stevens, and the league and Brendan Shanahan had said all those hits, as Ron had mentioned, would be legal. This is very much like it. This is a body-on-body, shoulder-on-shoulder hit. And that's one, a young player learning how to play in the National Hockey League. Bang, down he goes. And that, to me, is perfectly fine.
Nice for the LA Kings, but on the road, they haven't done as much, and they haven't done much against the Stars.
My goodness, Stahl is bump checked at center ice. He got flattened by the new guy, Demers.
They were killing. He was involved this time in an old-fashioned open ice hip check on Stahl. Had his head buried and kabang. Wow. It has been eons since we've seen somebody blown up or hit turbulence like that through the middle of the rink.
20. John Carlson picks it back up. 8 goals on the year for Carlson. That pass for Grabowski, he was tied up at center ice. And now the play is offside.
Carlson to step up in the neutral zone, and he flattens Grabowski. Grabowski thinks he's got a little bit of time. You see when Grabowski's getting the puck, he's not moving side to side across the ice. He's sliding up the ice. That brings him closer to the defenseman and makes an excellent skater like Carlson that much more likely to read that step up into the play. That's an excellent read and then finish by Erik Karlsson.
Chad up there trying to stir things up. Puck comes to Gilbert. Rolls it up the middle, and that's what happens. Beaulieu was flattened.
He read that one so well. Nathan Beaulieu thinks he's going to slide underneath, pick a breakout pass. You are not anticipating their defense. Watch Carlson, 65. He reads it. He's going forwards. Everyone else coming back. Perfectly clean. Perfectly timed. And oh my goodness, what a hit from Erik Karlsson, who is such a slight guy, and yet he can still play very physically. And J.J. Daniels saying, that's all right, hang in there. It's been a tough period so far for Nathan Beaulieu. The turnover, the hits. And the boys in the bench are Ottawa loving the performance of their captain so far in this game.
Touching it is that if you've never won it and you touch it, you will never win it.
Back near side, Gomez. Rodney Knight made sure not to put that whammy on. Passed out near side, Sikora tried to draw it around, but and down on the ice.
Steven Stahl, oh my goodness.
Is that Paul Kariya?
Yes, it is.
Paul Kariya,
oh,
leveled
by, and
by
he's
Scott
had,
Stevens.
He's had cushion problems in the past. This is the first open ice big hit that Scott Stevens has thrown in the series. Paul Kariya landed on his back and didn't move. Oh my, I'm not sure, guys, where the puck was at the time. Looks like he wants to get up on his own and show some toughness here, but he went on his back and he never moved. And look at the wobbly, look at his legs. Oh, baby.
Guarantee he doesn't know where he is.
Coach Babcock, well, here's the play. Puck in his feet, on his stick. He moves it. Oh, guys, that's interference.
Never saw that coming because Stevens came from his right and he was looking left. Paul Kariya.
Here's Oposo trying to keep it in. It's knocked down and brought on by Scheifele. The Schrader ice! And another was checked by McCabe! And now everybody going after McCabe. They'll all pile in there!
That's Patrick Laine who McCabe hit. The 229s colliding right at center ice.
And Jake McCabe, he's cut bad on his face, and he's going to go to the room. But the hit that he laid on Laine right there in the middle of the ice. was a devastating hit right there, and he put him down. And Laine, Patrick Laine, he had no idea he was in serious trouble, and he still is.
It's almost like they're two heads hit.
I'll tell you, Laine could not get up off the ice after the hit, and now he's slowly coming around. But you're going to see him right there. He plays the puck, and as he does, Jake McCabe just stands him straight up. And then everybody converges in off that, but Patrick Laine still down on the ice, slowly getting up now.
Riley clears it up. The Leafs responded to the last Calgary goal by scoring one of their own less than a minute later. We'll see what they do here. Kadri trying to drive to the net, and he was pounded by Giordano. And Kadri groggily gets up. Puck played up ahead. Jones trying to come in. Knocked away from him. Under a minute to go in the first period. Gardner.
And I mean, Kadri didn't leg him much. Kadri's got the puck. His head is down. Giordano just steps up. I mean, to me, that's a good hockey hit. Now, Kadri's saying, you know, was it a head contact? Kadri going to the bench. I mean, he doesn't like it at all.
Bag went off for a leak and right off the goalpost, too.
I think Nazem Kadri's telling Giordano, you're off the Christmas card list.
That was a perfect scenario for the captain on that one. You've got a guy with traffic all around, and Kadri was focused so much on the puck, had his head down for a split second. And
6 minutes into this second overtime, Kessler with speed across the line. Oh, what a hit! Holy jumping!
Here's Kessler making the move from the outside in. He loses it for a second. He looks up and gets blown away by Murray. Murray comes in. That's a great look at Murray. Seeing the opportunity, seeing what Kessler wants to do coming into the middle and making him pay big time. Love those open ice hits like that.
5-on-3 this season. Mitchell's back out. And what a hit! Oh, he caught Taves. And Taves still down. Rock! Breakaway! And it's going to be wiped out by a response. Now this is a real double whammy for Vancouver, because they get robbed of a scoring chance on a clean hit by Willie Mitchell on Jonathan Taves.
Taves came back to the bench, dropped a little bit of an expletive, and said, I had my head down. Well, he got blindsided. This is a clean hit from Willie Mitchell. Mitchell comes out of the penalty box. The Blackhawks pass the puck to Taves, and he has no idea where Mitchell is. But Taves is just looking for the puck, and there's no reason for Mitchell to be there except he's coming out of the penalty box. This is a clean hit. Taves goes down. He's at the penalty, or he's at the players' bench here talking to the trainer. You can see him stumble. He's obviously in some distress.